Welcome to the ArchiFrame new features video, where we will be going through the new features of ArchiFrame that is now compatible with the latest Archicad, Archicad 28. In this video, we'll be breaking down the most important top 10 features of the software update, but remember that by checking the customer area, you can always find a more detailed version history log with all the recent updates. The first feature we wanted to show you is that the automatically updating views function is now working correctly. This long-awaited fix to the automatically updating views function will help you save time and ensure you don't have to keep switching between ArchiCAD and ArchiFrame. When you select automatically update layouts via ArchiCAD views, any changes you make will be reflected in both views and layouts. Here, when we make some changes to the ArchiFrame planks, and we update, the changes are reflected everywhere and can be seen in the layout as well. There's also a new tool for metal connectors. Here are some real-life examples of the sorts of connectors we can now create in ArchiFrame. Let's take a look at the possibilities with some examples. Let's start with end to side. Let's get the other part, activate the operator, and choose a connector. Let's place a little gap in between them and then click Do. There we have it. Let's take a look at this in 3D. Here you can see the ready slot for the metal plate. The tool also supports connecting angled pieces. Let's get the other part, choose the operator, and for this one, we need a larger metal connector. Finally, we click Do. And there we have it. Let's do that connection again. As you can see, the pieces here overlap. Let's see what happens. Let's get the other part and activate the operator. And let's go with the same settings here. As you can see, the tool takes care of the overlap as well. Next, let's look at an end-to-end connection. We'll get the other part and activate the operator. Let's not use a gap this time. There we have it, and in the 3D section as well. Finally, let's take a look at the side-to-side connection. In this case, we should not have the other part selected. So without anything selected, let's get the other part. As you can see, the select button here turns gray, meaning that there's no selection stored. And in this case, we choose the pieces to be connected with no settings other than the connector itself and click Do. Then we place the connector at the desired position. And there we have it in 3D section as well. The connectors are all edited in XML. Here you can see the coordinates for the plate. Here are the coordinates for the drillings and some more settings for the fitting of the metal plate itself. Board panel views. Improvements have also been made to the way the board panel can be viewed. In this particular situation, the top view shows projections both below and above ArchiCAD's floor plan cut plane. Similarly, in the section, the corresponding projected surfaces are shown according to the way the section marker is placed. Now let's take a closer look at the model view options. The projections above cut plane and below cut plane are active. Here, we can superimpose the back projection onto the front projection. For this purpose, I've created a drilling on the back side of the board, and it is now showing in a different color and a different line type. Changing the position of the floor plan cut plane will affect the view. Let's set the cut plane to around this area. As we can see, the whole board is now cut. Remember that the section view will be affected by the position of the section marker. Surface quality markings follow a common factory standard. Let's take a look at it in 3D. Not visible surfaces will be portrayed with one line and visible surfaces with two lines. Here are some of the different possible configurations. Both visible, both front and back. The front visible, the back not visible. The back visible and the front not visible. And both surfaces not visible. These marking texts can also be freely composed and they can be controlled in the XML file itself. Copy-pasting. Machinings can now be copy-pasted from one ArchiCAD project to another. Let's choose this board edge and copy it to a board in another project. Next, let's copy-paste these two drillings over to the other board in the project. Complete elements can also now be copy-pasted. With an update, the element drawing for the copied element now appears. You can also copy-paste components from one element to another. Let's select that one and copy it to its neighboring element. There we have it. Randek Export is now supported. We have added CNC support for the Randek Framing Station using the CDT version 3.1. Let's export a simple element with an opening and some insulation by using element options. First, generate the automatic opening module IDs. This will create the openings as sub-elements in CDT. Now, let's export this element and see the final results in the CDT viewer. Planks can now explode their surrounding insulation into multiple pieces. This now happens automatically as planks are moved, added, or deleted in an element. Here is an element with a top baulk, and as I move it around, insulation is automatically generated around it. If we change the plank width to something smaller, it will create a hole rather than splitting the surrounding insulation. Insulation settings can be controlled in the core layer settings to control how big a plank needs to be to explode the insulation. New lifting support blocks. You can now automatically create support blocks with the surrounding drillings. First, select which studs the support block should be created for. Then, go to Support Blocks with Surrounding Drillings under Special Operations in the Plank Settings. Please refer to the manual regarding the correct settings here. Press OK, and the support blocks with surrounding drillings are automatically created. Saw cuts. There are some new settings that we have added to saw cuts. The layer thickness will determine the depth of the cut when marking it zero. Positive values for moving the saw will move it outwards, and negative value will move it inwards. Adding millings to inner corners will create neat corners. The overcut is not needed in these cases. Let's see what happens when we put this into practice. Saw cuts can be limited by the marquee tool. Pick limiting marquee and then remove the marquee, choose the boards, and create saw cuts. Down in the left corner is an indication that it's being limited to the marquee. There we go. The marquee limitation is removed by not having a marquee at all and picking that as a marquee. Now the marquee limitation is gone. Saw cuts can also be limited to a selection only. Angle double top and bottom. The double top and bottom function also now handles angled parts. Here you can see how the angled parts are included in the function. New built-in layouts. We've created three new layout templates that come with the ArchiFrame package. With all of these new layout templates, you have the choice to turn projections either on or off. Remember that for more information regarding any of these options and related settings, you can refer to the manual by pressing Alt-Shift F1 or following the link in the video description. Please download the latest ArchiFrame from your customer area if you're an ArchiFrame user, and feel free to provide feedback on any of these new features. Remember that these are not all the changes and features we have included in the latest ArchiFrame. You can find details of that from the customer area in the version log. Thank you very much.